That's a lot of smart.
There we
smarts.
Go.
That we can
What's gonna happen?
Happen to?
What?
Keith.
Ooh.
I've gotten three out of four events so far. God damn.
Fuck you.
Nothing's better after a hard week of paying zero attention
hey, it's
at
one
school
of each of us.
Than blowing off steam by blowing things up. You, Liam, Damien, Polly, Effie, and Andrea are having an awesome time drinking and causing destruction for personal property when suddenly someone brings up how we're all leaving out Bird and we laugh. Everything goes black. You wake up an unspecified amount of time later in the darkness, hazy and chained.
Dude, shit. Am I tripping really hard, or are we chained up to it in a well or something?
I thought you had a thing. Ghost had a thing for being chained or with chains.
I don't know.
Why are you complaining? What?
She's into it. From somewhere apparently far above, you hear the shrieking cackles of the Slayer. Oh.
Oh, come on.
Wow, yes, everyone's
you
here.
You are.
Except you.
And the well is being filled with water, and soon you'll drown. Guess you should be more careful when accepting drinks from strangers.
Nah, it sounds like something pussies would do.
Girl, this is so uncool. I know you have something going on with Damien and Liam, but me? Come on, empowered women empower women.
Water starts pouring in, but nobody seems especially scared.
If you think about it, this was a pretty shitty plan. I don't need to breathe, and Polly can just phase out.
Yeah, why not just stake you through the haunt while you will... Oh, whoa. Why not just stake you through the haunt while you were drunk or chop my head off?
So everyone's a critic now, huh? No, but seriously, girl, I'm just going to disappear in a minute and reappear somewhere else. So as far as I'm concerned, the big takeaway from this experience was that I got a free drink. And free drugs in that free drink.
That's all well and good, but you're not sure how resistant to asphyxiation you and your other buddies are.
I'm a shadow. I don't have to worry about this. What are you talking about?
Shh. Also, I'm a zombie.
I'm made of fire.
You might be in trouble.
Yeah,
you probably are having a real bad day.
This is the Charmander problem. Yeah. I think I'll die if my head goes out.
Oh, no. You look around the well. There are tons of coins people have tossed in over the years to make a wish, along with a few random pieces of trash that people have decided to discard. Or maybe threw them in to also make wishes? Who's to say?
Is that an old pamphlet on Episcopalian principles?
I know. I was distracted by that rusty iron bear trap.
And I'm just living for this glow-in-the-dark dildo.
Oh my god. Wow.
Wait,
why does it need a glow-in-the-dark?
Anyway. So you don't lose it. I mean, are you can, you know, you can masturbate in the daylight and the dark. It doesn't
matter.
Well,
she's probably partially transparent, so if she's used in the dark, never mind.
She's don't using it as a light. She's using it to be a living nightlight.
That sounds terrible.
Or I suppose an undead nightlight in this cave.
Oh my god.
Wait.
That's such a fucking thought.
Maybe we can use them to escape. I feel weakened from the drugs, which is lame. But I bet I can break one person out who can free all of us using these three random items.
Oh.
But who should it be? Heath, you seem to know everyone's business. What do you think?
Oh, good question. Which one of your friends could use an Episcopalian pamphlet, a bear trap, and a dildo to escape from a well?
Someone high creative.
Between you two.
I have...
Definitely Effie. He's an artist. What? This well, his canvas, and the Episcopalian pamphlet, bear trap, and dildo in his are his paints. We'll go out here in the we'll be out here in the blink of an artistic eye. Are you kidding? Andrea is the best-selling author of the non-fiction work How to Escape from a Well Using a Religious Paraphernalia Hunting Gear and a Sex Toy. That's a way better title. Their moment has finally arrived.
I feel like that one's probably going to require smarts for that one for Andrew.
No.
Or
it's
creativity?
I think it's a creative check, period. So the question is which of you has...
Remember what your creativity was, Andrew?
Yeah, the question is which of you has the best one. Because it literally hides it from me, so I can't check.
Yeah, Keith is supposed to use his memory.
You know what?
We're not supposed to help him.
He's just supposed to remember.
I heard the buildup, and I was like, oh, please be smart. It's because Effie has a billion, and it just happened, so I remember. Andrew's been to the fun place and got money. Literally nobody out of all of us has a single time has gone to the auditorium.
None of us are focusing on it.
We have incidental creativity at best. Fuck.
I feel like Andrew's been
one of you is like tragically low.
I wish I could help you. I mean, I guess I can. I guess I still technically can.
No. But.
What's gonna happen?
Creativity? No, I got creativity from doing smarts. Yeah, as an event.
Yeah.
That was me.
Chat,
shit. My memory is myself.
Chat, go ahead and just rewind the video a little bit and let us know.
I literally just did that just because I was curious.
You're not chat. You're not allowed to do that.
I mean, I'm technically in the chat. Thank you very much.
You wouldn't fail me after I hooked you up last time, would you, Andrea?
Nice.
I knew I had a lot of creativity because I got some FBI.
Yeah, I had four creativity. That would have been so bad.
I remember somebody being so low.
Yeah. Yeah.
Great. Andrea it is then. Get ready to be busted out of your chains with demon strength.
So mote it be. With a flash of devilish
muscle.
With a flash of devilish muscle, Andrea is now free to begin their brilliant work. Stacking the dildo, the Episcopalian pamphlet, the bear trap, and the bear trap, one on top of another, held together by some of the pennies Andrea's cobbled together. My long-lost brother? The Slayer yells from somewhere above the well. Is that your silhouette I see, Salil?
Yes, it is! And if you don't stop this right now, he'll drown with us!
Quick as a flash, the Slayer stops the water and jumps down into the well, where she was devoured like the pickle. Damien steals the keys off of her, knocks her out, frees the rest of you, and all six of you escape from the well.
Aw. Damn, I'm strong. Good choice, Keith, for telling me how I should use my amazing strength.
And well done, Andrea, as well. Truly, that sculpture was incredibly beautiful. It belongs in a modern art exhibit.
It belongs in a museum.
She's legit like... That dildo looks just like my brother.
Oh no.
It's at least the second or third most beautiful sculpture of an Episcopalian pamphlet, bear trap, and dildo I've ever seen in my life.
What? And I like the part where we made the Slayer look like an idiot. And where I got a free drink and free drugs in it.
Always fun.
It looks like a win-win-win-win-win-win situation because all six of you walked away winners. But most importantly, you and Andrea both win 3 boldness. Oh.
Damn.
Yes.
Damn.
And you all walk away alive. Or in the afterlife, or undead, or whatever.
You think Polly's name is a pun on polyamory?
Maybe. Yeah.
It doesn't come up yet in the game. I keep waiting for it.
It's like Poltergeist and... I think it's also Polly because she is like a party girl.
Yeah, like I guess Scott's the protagonist of Teen Wolf.
Yeah.
Everybody
I just keep waiting for it to be a Polly Amory joke, but it hasn't
come up
yet.
Maybe she's Polly Pocket. I don't know.
My occupation is polyamory therapist.
Damn. Cool.
Couples counseling.
That's why I collect 3 paychecks.
Oh boy. I like the idea that you have like a circle couch.
You charge by the head.
Just, like, circles in on itself.
All right.
Go ahead.
No, go for it.
I'm gonna go with Mortician.
I'm gonna pick God.
Are you having trouble thinking of what the word is?
No, I'm just trying to think of, like, what's an occupation that's not just, like, something boring. Like, I'm trying to think of something that's not, like, too polarizing.
What programmer.
Yeah, like, I don't want something that is, like, way too in one direction or the other, because it's going to be something random.
Picking
and I don't want to be, like,
You don't want to try to get one because you might get four.
Yeah, exactly. I'm gonna say an astronaut.
Nice. I'm gonna say senior assistant fluffer.
Also charges by the head. Player orders decided based on how funny a TV show called America's Next Fluffer would be.
Oh, damn it. I think Bird
went down.
Oh, wow. I don't think you can do that. America's Next Senior damn. Fluffer. America's Next Polyamory couples therapist.
I'm last again.
Astronaut and mortician.
I don't know. Yeah. I think America's Next would be more interesting than astronaut.
Yeah, but
it's like not funny. Fluffer ones. Astronauts are not funny
Jesus
at all.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
That's why you pick an extreme, lost. Andrew.
Astronauts
are pretty fucking extreme.
Damn it.
Yeah. Extreme altitude.
I'm glad I went with mortician instead of my original answer was going to be aircraft mechanical engineer.
God. That would have been awful.
I mean, mortician, even if it's a funny therapist, I think mortician beats therapist. How do you become
really? Especially because it's poly.
How do you televise America's Next Therapist in any context? Like, what is that show?
You know, that's fair.
I don't think that our world's ready for that level of nuanced take on mental health on TV.
Oh boy.
I think no one's gonna watch that show. Effie.
Wow.
Fuck, yeah, astronaut wins.
What?
Oh my God.
How is astronaut better than yours? Bong. What?
Because nobody wants to watch a fucking show about training therapists.
Are you kidding me? Dr. Phil's
astronaut.
Literally an entire show.
He's not training other people to be Dr. Phil Letts.
He's training himself to be a therapist, and everyone's been watching it for years.
He's so awful.
Yeah, but people keep coming back. Like,
I guess I was more optimistic about the couples therapist being good at their job and not ruining people's lives.
Yeah.
Oh, Bird, you're up.
Let's see. What are my stats? Charm 11, money 9. Let's, I don't really know what stats I want, but I feel like charm and money are probably the ones. So I feel good about where I'm at right now. Oh, library's already taken.
Yep.
I'll leave it to somebody else to take the store this round. I don't think I need it. So to that end, I don't know. Kind of. Does anyone else need the gin, or can I just take it again?
I'm gonna be grabbing the. Oh, damn it, there goes my money-making opportunity there. Fucking library!
Yeah.
How much was the cocaine?
10.
Fuck. Oh, wow.
It implies there's multiple fluffers on set. Well, yeah, somebody's gonna get fucking tired. You need the backups.
The fluffer trainee.
Somebody's gotta learn on the job.
Don't Google that. If you're
anyway,
go Google that. I'm googling it.
Stop
right
watching
now,
my channel
live
if you're
on stream.
Don't watch this series if you're underage.
All right, whatever. Let's do. Okay, well, what would be the cutest outfit to see Miranda in? that's what we need to pick.
Well,
auditorium's out. Class is probably out.
You don't
or
like
outdoors,
her Daisy
right?
costume?
Which one? Oh. And no one's going to take creativity. No one needs it. So I don't mind taking it as a dump to let other people get what they need. Mm-hmm. So let's do auditorium and see her Daisy outfit.
So cute. Aw, look at her.
Yeah.
That day, while rehearsing for the class play, it's as though the muses themselves had descended to give you figurative oral sex.
Why only figurative?
Wow. Well, you're wearing armor. It's hard to give you literal.
God damn it. We'll make it work. Whatever.
Your performance is intense and inspiring as the senior fluffer.
Just like the oral sex.
It'll be remembered for generations, which is pretty rad by high school play standards. You gain 2 creativity. You're minding your own business when Miranda comes rushing up to you, clearly distraught.
Most terrible news, friend. I have just watched the documentary Game of Thrones, now I fear for my own royal family. I did not realize how susceptible we might be to random acts of treachery, or how often we romance our siblings.
Yeah, I'm like, it's definitely an incest joke. Here we go.
I don't want to be shot in the chest by a crossbow while sitting on the toilet. That doesn't sound proper at all. Please, help me put my poor mind at ease. How can I possibly identify potential traitors in my court?
Just keep an eye out. Well, first of all, only live peasants can stage a rebellion. Keep an eye out for the classic signs. Shifty eyes, hooded black cloaks, ordering knives in bulk. Pretty much everyone's a traitor. Just spin a bottle and whoever it points at, kill them.
Oh, fuck.
The first one is quite literally just like, hey, the royal chef is buying a bunch of knives for everyone in the kitchen.
It's pretty sus.
Pretty sus.
The first one is probably smarts. I have no idea what the second one is, but it's not smarts. So
it's definitely
creativity?
A safer bet.
Yeah.
Or fun. Creativity. I don't know.
It might be I don't know. Smarts. I feel like I'm going to I feel like neither of these are going to look good, so... let's just do the second one. I feel slightly better about it.
So bold.
Okay. Nice.
Just shoot someone at random. That. See what happens. Miranda's so excited by your advice that she skips out on school to try it immediately.
Oh my god.
The next day, she finds you in the hall, clearly overwhelmed.
Yay.
Two cute outfits. Anyway.
The most wondrous, glorious news, friend. The traitor is caught. The kingdom is saved. If not for your shrewd method of detecting, I might never have discovered the treachery of Balthazar the Loyal.
And we also invented Russian spin the bottle.
Oh my God.
Wow. He raised me from an infant, tried to teach me right from wrong, never betrayed my father nor myself. The perfect cover. Thank you for singing. The perfect cover for a traitor. I might have gone my whole life not knowing his true nature, had not the spinning bottle cut through his layer of deceit. Would you like to accompany me to the execution later? There will be popcorn!
The popcorn is very good. You try not to think too much about whether Balthazar is actually guilty. Either way, you gain 2 fun and 1 charm.
All right.
God, I am killing this playthrough.
Literally.
Yeah.
Aha! Thank you.
It's Effie. He's not last. So much
not,
freedom.
I'm gonna go ahead and go. What are the locations again for the? I'm gonna go to the bathrooms.
For
I need some
boldness?
Charm in my life.
Going.
Bathroom is
oh,
boldness.
Oh wait, charm. Jim.
Jim is charm. Because it's actually about because Jim is actually war and you are the general. That day, an epic dodgeball battle takes place. Amidst the battle, you spot a fellow player that seems utterly discouraged. She thinks she is not worth anything at dodgeball, and she attempts to throw a ball at herself. Hilarious.
What?
You explain to her the many, many ways you think she's unique and wonderful while also defending the many pleasures in life. With your help, she's capable of finding reasons to keep playing and gains a sense of self-worth. You gain +1 BFF. Sadly, she's not part of the game, so that's a beautiful relationship that will be happening off-screen. And 2 charm. Later, you see Liam beaming at himself. Liam? Beaming?
It appears that my application to write for Virtue Magazine was received and accepted.
He wears the exercise undershirt.
I knew my pitch would hook him. Imagine the edgiest, most irrelevant article subject you could think of. Now double it. That's my article subject. You see, I used a writing technique on them called lying. It's very effective.
up until they call your bluff. Now I've got to actually write an article, and I've got no idea what to write. You, save me from the consequences of my actions. Suggest an idea that lives up to my own hype.
What? A passionate argument for the legalization of recreational chimera toxins. A chilling expose of the pasta industry's griffin trafficking.
I'm gonna go with the second one.
Wow. Continuity.
Wow.
That's probably gonna be boldness, I would imagine.
He's not even the same. He's not even from that story.
Nope.
Oh, nice. Yeah,
boldness.
Ah, yes.
Magizoological.
Don't read it out to me. This isn't fucking kindergarten. Give me a second. How'd it go again? I'm kidding. God damn it. Shut up. Magizoological welfare is a very hot topic right now. And I just had griffin pasta the other day. And it was delicious. But if the suffering of the griffins is greater than the deliciousness of their taste, then this is something the public must know about, specifically from me.
Soon thereafter, you see a piece in Virtue by new correspondent Liam DeLioncourt. Griffin pasta, delicious but deadly. For the griffin, not for you. Wait, does this mean you have to stop eating griffin pasta? Whatever. You gain 2 smarts and 1 boldness.
I am so nice. Smart.
Congrats.
I am so smart.
Andrea.
Oh, it's I mine.
So S-M-R-T. I mean, S-M-A-R.
I kind of want to do money again because I need money for drugs.
You can't get money.
Fuck, why is the store in the money place?
I know!
I get money.
I need money.
I'm not even close to having enough money. Fuck.
Yep, there will only be 1 more chance to get money because there's only 1 more day of school.
Oh my god, so
I have to commit to something. Let's go to class. No. Yeah, let's go to class.
Class. That day, the teacher is just tired of teaching, so she recurs to the classic technique of not giving a shit and putting on some kind of historical TV show for you to watch. What you don't expect is this, is that it's super effective. God bless the golden era of television. The TV show is compelling thanks to the ridiculous amount of nudity and bloodshed, but at the same time, you actually learn a lot about history. You gain 2 smarts. I watched Shrek in school. In high school.
Some.
Funny.
That's definitely where you want to get all of your historical lessons from.
It was my German teacher would just show us movies in German. It's like some of them were German, some of them were just movies dubbed in German. So we watched Shrek 2 at one point.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
What does Shrek sound like in German?
German.
Does he have an accent?
I don't know accents in German. I was trying to learn German at all, let alone figuring out what the German accents are from each other.
Auf meine Schwamp.
Oh my god.
Wait.
You're hard at work reorganizing your collection of magic stickers when you're interrupted by Polly.
Hiya, can you help me with my homework? I have to write an essay on the perks of being a ghost. But I am a ghost, you know? So I've never stopped to wonder what the best part is. Now I have to examine my life, and it's kind of launching me into like a existential crisis. What is the true nature of self? Is the mind separate from the body? What does it mean to be alive?
Or unlive.
Which is weird to worry about because, like, I'm not alive. I don't like thinking this hard. Thinking hard is how I died. Don't ask me to explain that. What should I say in my paper?
Binge drinking all night without ever having to pee. Going skydiving, but your parachute is a live shark and you're jumping into a volcano and give no fucks. Wow, I wonder what stat that could be. Could that be the exact stat you need?
That's probably the fun answer.
No? Definitely boldness.
That's the bold eight, yeah.
First one's probably fun. That's cartoonishly bold. That's some fucking Trogdor shit.
I'm gonna have to go with the second option here. Oh my god. Yes! Holy hell, I don't even want to write this essay anymore. I just want to go skydiving with a shark parachute into a volcano. With spear sticking out of it and a bomb strapped to my chest. And a chainsaw instead of a safety belt. And my goggles are scorpions.
Oh my god.
Polly wanders off, still planning excitedly. You're not certain she's going to get her homework done, but there are more important things in life. Or, you guess, in death? You gain two fun and one boldness. Now the question is whether Effie fucked me or improved my chances with his stuff.
What?
Wait, was it? Who told Liam to write the paper? Was that Effie?
I did, yeah.
Because you slandered Griffin pasta, and I got a thing going on, but we did just learn how to make it not out of Griffin, so maybe we're set, actually? I'm not sure. I'm going to go to library, because
well,
I should probably...
Yeah,
maybe
it's, make...
they're not connected at all.
I like to
spend maybe your business looks better, because it doesn't use Griffins.
Yeah, we're Griffin. We can brand it Griffin-free.
Yeah.
Yep. Impossible pasta. Impossible.
Oh, no.
Imposter pasta.
Yeah. Impossible paradise. Stupid.
Good old Keith. What's it gonna be today?
Terrifying condom. Not condom. Tampon. I don't know why I'm looking at other people's stats.
Check the drugs. Tell me how much it costs.
It costs 10, I told you.
Damn it. I just want to confirm it, though.
Yeah, it's the exact thing I tried to buy last time, and then I'm like, oh, fuck, it's really expensive. And then I bought the stupid gift and ruined my playthrough because I wasted a turn coming to the store for a thing I couldn't afford. I'm very bold, but what if I was also... I can't be smart. It's impossible to be smart. Shit.
You could be fun or charming.
Yeah.
Or I guess just get your creativity up the shit. Like...
Create for what, bro?
Well, because
I'm gonna Bob Ross it.
Yeah. I was gonna say, have you needed charm or fun?
Like, creativity just helps you improvise when you're being bold. It's how all of my D&D characters survive.
Oh,
nothing better than the smell of money. Well, actually, there's many better smells, but you know what I mean, right? Everybody chooses a movie. Say that choice out loud to the rest of your players before clicking.
Event Horizon.
We're going. We don't need eyes.
The chances are pretty. This is a pretty mid-tier choice.
I looked at my shelf and almost said the same Cowboy Bebop Blu-ray from last time.
Don't. What the fuck's wrong with you? Is that the only movie you own?
It's the only one that's I can see from here because it's not spine facing. It's just. Cover facing. Society. Does anyone know Society? Does that reference even make sense?
Is it a Joker?
No, it's the movie it's a movie about the rich where they are all giant. They're all trying to be like a giant flesh mob merging into a body horror slop.
I see. I'm gonna go with The Little Mermaid 2, Sebastian's Big Day.
Is that really what it's called?
No, I have no idea if there even is a sequel to it. I just thought that'd be funny.
I think they did straight to VHS sequels of everything in that era.
I'm sure. All right, so we're gonna go with The Little Mermaid 2, Sebastian's Big Day.
I would guess it's called Ursula's Revenge.
I'm gonna go with The Sector.
The Sector?
The Sector.
So we have a hypothetical movie and a movie I haven't heard of. And Event Horizon.
The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea.
Oh.
It came out in 2000. But we're still going with Sebastian's Big Day.
All right. Player has decided based on how bizarre of an action figure based on the selected movie would be. All right, so Bert
I probably
loses.
Come in last. Yeah, I was going to say. They're going to merchandise movie? The shit out of it. Yeah.
What is The Sector?
They'd definitely lose.
It's a dystopian future. Bounty hunters capturing outlaws.
Got
through the world of multiverses.
So completely unbizarre to make an action figure out of it.
I mean, all right, I'm going to read you the
real. I mean, it sounds like every YA dystopia that people literally make action figures out of. Sounding a lot like third place, bro.
Probably, yeah.
Damn.
I mean, it's a finisher versus the body horror movie.
I don't know.
I mean, they're technically both body horror movies.
Yeah, in their own ways. Where we're going, we don't need eyes. Is that even from that movie?
That
Am I making that up?
So that depends. Like, well, no, that you're that's the right movie because you, if you have eyes, you can see hell. And remember, like every time they jump, it's going to hell. So you don't want to be able to see it. The anyways, the point is that my question would be:
Society's really fucked up. Have you seen Society?
I haven't seen it. It's like, what would you make a toy out of, I guess? What would be
the toy? It's pretty rough. There's a part where somebody gets a hand shoved up their ass and it comes out of their mouth and then their entire body melts into a meat puppet.
So, not PG.
No.
That seems pretty interesting to make an action figure out of. You'd have, like, could you stick the hand into the action figure?
Remember that scene of Extro where he blows a bubble in that kid's neck?
Yeah.
And also the birthing scene, I guess. What if the whole movie was like, what if the whole climax was just like 30 minutes of shit like that? That's Society kind of. It's so
that
much.
That seems.
I need to watch Extro again.
It seems like it would be tough, but probably more interesting. Because I think Event Horizon would probably just be like the
I feel
crew,
like Event Horizon might have an action figure.
It probably does. But I feel like it would just be the crew, and then maybe if you're lucky, there might be like an additional package you could buy that has like the hell scene.
Is the turn order perfectly right to left?
It might be, yeah.
I think that's the order. Disney was definitely the dog of this round.
That's Disney the dog. To say. All right.
Yeah.
Damn.
Well, because.
Yeah, no. It was the dog. You're right.
Yeah, because when you picked dog, it was the most perfect storm of the worst possible thing that the prompt could have been for. Oh,
yeah.
Fuck. Well, I spent my money, so I'm not going there.
Of the beach.
Oh, thank goodness. I don't think anybody's going to go for the table that I'm going to sit at.
Ba-doop, 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 boop. Maximum Damien points.
Oh,
no!
You stolen the bird.
Shouldn't have said Disney. No sooner have you sat down at Damien and Miranda's table than a haunting melody fills the air. It is a melody of cold northern peaks, of cloying sweetness, of a supple bovine teat.
What? Oh,
what? The song of...
The ice cream wizard!
Oh my god.
He's here! He's here! I'm gonna eat so much ice cream and then puke on someone I don't like!
Oh, goodness! The ice cream wizard only comes but once per solstice during the hour of the ascended pancake!
What? You see an old dude in a floppy blue hat pushing a refrigerated cart with this shit magic painted on the side.
Wow.
What even is this game? I swear.
It's beautiful.
This game's so good.
It's so much better than Yogg.
Damn.
It's better than Wilder Myth.
That's just because of the fact that Wilder Myth is broken as fuck and it has terrible writing.
Yeah, just just because of the parts that are the game.
So many great options to choose. Should I get Magma Bar, Brain Destroyer, Chocolate Broomstick, or Boomstick? I'm sorry. What about Feeder of Death, Frozen Cobra, Berserker Berry Blitz?
They got through an entire prompt without saying dildo.
Just didn't give them time.
I mean, I was trying to jinx it.
Ah, yeah.
The wizard's frozen teats.
Let's retry that.
something on the mind bird.
No. The wizard's frozen teats invariably turn me into a frog for some reason. Perhaps I simply have not tried the right one yet.
Teat yourself.
But which to try? If only someone would suggest a solution to what is truly the most difficult problem I have ever faced.
Try those sugar-basted prince lips. Beat him up and take all his ice cream. Fuck, it's me. I forgot.
Yeah.
Shit. I mean, that's definitely bold. Oh, fuck. I was supposed to think about that, but I picked right. Okay, good.
Yeah, you're fine. How boorish.
I forgot the context of the choice.
Did someone say bull rush?
No. I said boorish, as in lacking social... I see. You did not mishear me after all, but we're simply looking for an excuse to beat up the ice cream lizard.
And you said teat on purpose.
Yes.
Joke's on you, Miranda. I'm never not looking for an excuse to beat up the ice cream wizard. Damn. Look at this ice cream I got. This one lets you breathe underwater, and this one licks you.
You brigand! You thief!
I got you some sugar-basted prince lips.
My reservations suddenly seem to have vanished.
Good, because I want to try this popsicle. This stick is supposed to reveal how I'm gonna die! Who knew my death would involve so many bottlenose dolphins?
Oh no. To celebrate the ice cream heist, Damien takes you to the beach and doesn't even try to drown you.
Let's nice. Do this.
Maybe he died. Maybe he dies in the cove.
I'm gonna go to the top left.
No!
Oh, damn it! I need to go there. I'm there. Damn it!
Sorry.
Oh, I hate you.
You take your seat, and if you didn't know any better, you would say it seems like Vera and Polly are almost more interested in their phones than they are in you. And you do know better, and you know that. Yes, this is exactly what's happening right now.
Hey there.
Nothing personal, Andrea.
Andrea?
Yeah.
Whatever.
Andrea.
It's just that Polly and I are very engrossed in texting our financial slave.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to compete with some guy whose fetish is buying you anything you want. That's my fetish too. Not buying things for people, having people buy things for me, duh. A good thing he's rich enough to take care of both of us. You know what they say, true friendship is sharing secrets and financial slaves.
Still, I do wonder or worry that this arrangement might not be sustainable. What happens if he runs out of money? Our cash flow instantly stops. Besides, being handed everything you want on a platter... In this case, the platter being an online money transferring platform. Is almost... boring?
Yeah, I get that. It's a little less boring when you're on as much acid as I am right now, but I see what you mean.
If we could somehow turn this into a business venture, then maybe it will get interesting. And we could continue to profit even after he's gone broke from catering to every whim.
So OnlyFans?
Oh my god.
I mean, how interesting do you think business actually is? Since he's so obsessed with us, we should just tell him to do something totally insane and see if he does it.
I don't know. A weirdo giving away his money and getting into hijinks is great and all, but I want to start making real money.
And I think money is fine and all, but my favorite currency is chaos.
So crypto.
Well, that's just volatility.
Seems like the ladies are at a very exciting crossroads. Maybe a random bystander can give them a nudge in the right direction. You can easily grow this arrangement into a business. Just escalate and delegate. Have the financial slave go and acquire his own financial slave to give him money, and have that slave go and find a financial slave.
It is crypto.
Ponzi.
Tell him to marry a llama.
I mean, obviously.
Is Andrew on the fucking, like, threesome route?
What?
You've had both of them.
It is Polly. I told you.
I'm fine with that. That's both characters I'm trying to win, but I
have you been paying, have you been paying attention to who actually gets, like, a heart pop-up?
Yeah, it's always Polly.
Okay. I wonder which one might be the Polly choice.
The llama, I hope.
Yeah, so we're picking that one?
Yeah. Oh my god, yes. That is everything to me. I actually had a dream just like that one time. Except it wasn't a llama, it was an alpaca. And it wasn't a wedding, it was a
bar mitzvah.
What is it? Bar mitzvah.
The Jewy thing. I said that weird.
That's probably not the best.
Said that really weird. We're Jewish next time.
No, it's the Jewish coming of age ceremony.
Yeah. What? Anywho.
But the other, but other than that, it was exactly the same.
Oh yeah, I don't think this is my scene. I'm going to check on my illegal law firm. Catch you weirdos later.
There goes the threesome.
I'm texting the financial slave right now, telling him to marry a llama. Oh, he's already typing. Let's see. Andrea, you will never believe this. It turns out the financial slave actually has been talking to a llama for a few months now through a llama monster dating site. He says he's a commitment phobe and never really defined the terms of their relationship with the llama. And he keeps introducing the llamas as a friend, but he knows now it's because he was just scared of being hurt. He's taking this as a sure sign it's time to be brave and commit to the llama. And now they're headed to City Hall for a ceremony right now! Of course, he says he'll have to take his leave of our group chat, since his heart and wallet now belong to another. Specifically, a llama. Aw, isn't that the sweetest love story you've ever heard? I'm so glad we got to make it happen together.
That is the sweetest love story you've ever heard, or something. But hey, maybe you and Polly will end up having a love story of your own.
All right. Yeah, I hope so.